tell you that we've been through some fights together, particularly a couple of your elections. And I want you to tell Hillary when you go back that this area gave her 7 miles. This is a tough election. We can't take it as an easy one. It's almost dead even. The momentum is on our side, but I'm going to depend on you to make some harsh judgments in the election. It's not just an election on national issues or one party with a record and another party without a record. Both me and my opponent have records. I've been in office for 25 years, and I challenge anyone that if they want to know what I stand on a position, they can test my vote and see where I stand. On the other hand, I'm opposing an 11-year mayor of Hastings who has raised local taxes 70% on real estate, increased the earned income tax 20%. Like not attending to the city, not balancing the budget, bringing in toxic waste into the city, and having a prison right across the street from the jail. That's his record. Now that's a decision and a choice that the people of this district have. Do they want to look at my record and see what I have done and what I've contributed to, or do they want to replace me and give a promotion to a failed mayor? I'm with you on that. I don't want to do it either. And secondly, we've got some hard problems. We've gone through a recession. We've lost jobs. But I've been there through the years. You know, we were just going over some of the ideas and some of the jobs, thousands of them, that I have helped create over the years, and I'm still working on those jobs. And the reason I'm running for office is I know with the 25 years experience that I've had in the Congress and the ability to work with 5 presidents, that when we need something, I can pick up a telephone and reach the president right here. The country isn't faced with a simple election choice this year. It really affects us, the average people of America, the working people of America. What the Republicans want to do is cut taxes on the very wealthy, shift the burden of paying down or balancing the budgets of the working people of America, and worst of all, they want to cut and privatize Social Security and Medicare. Remember, Mayor Barletta was a chairman twice for our great President George W. Bush, who's responsible for the disaster that we're in. Would America want to go back to those failed days, to those failed lives? Absolutely not. That's why I'm asking you to put a special effort in. We have all friends and neighbors, you have emails, and you have a list of friends and Facebooks and everything else. If you will send a message, if you will ask these folks to help us out, get out and make sure they vote. The Democratic Party and a list of great Democratic candidates, Governor on down, the United States Senator, myself, our state legislators, state senators, can win this election handily right here in northeastern Pennsylvania. I have to tell you, I've had the occasion in my life to win and to lose. I've been in 28 elections. I've won 26 of them. And I lost 2, the special election and the primary election, when I first started in 1980. And to a large extent, there's some folks right in this room that were with me on that very time. And I remember, that was a tough election because we came very close within percentage points. And I made a fatal error as a politician. I was in Berwick, Pennsylvania, or in Bloomsburg, Pennsylvania. Someone asked me if I would come and speak at a breakfast the day after the election. And I was so enthused and thinking I was going to win, but certainly I'd like to start my campaign that way, and I said yes. The election night came and we lost. And we were up until 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning, and I had agreed to go down to breakfast, which at Bloomsburg's about an hour away, Mr. President. And I had to leave my house at 7 in the morning and get there at 8 o'clock for breakfast. So I came down a little early, about 7:15. My little daughter was 8 years old, and she was going to school, and she was waiting for a bus to take her. And she was sitting there fairly dejected, because she'd been up fairly late the night before, too. But she was very contemplative, very deliberate. And I couldn't understand whether, I was hoping she wasn't terribly depressed. I said, Bitsy, that's what we called Nancy at that time when she was still a kid. I said, Bitsy, don't be depressed. You know, we lost the election, we put on a good fight. Oh, she said, no, I'm not depressed, Daddy. She said, I was just thinking about why you lost. And I said, well, what is that? And she said, Daddy, you didn't have enough friends. She was right. I didn't have enough friends. But Mr. President, I have you as a friend. The greatest part of my service in the Congress of the United States, it was in serving with you and traveling across America on several of these occasions. Remember that job we took and the work we did together. And I can only say, if Bitsy were her, tomorrow morning when I call her up, perhaps even election night, but I hope to be able to call Nancy, now we call her Nancy, and say, you know, now Daddy has enough friends because we won. These are my friends. My hometown, my other best friend, the Honorable William Jefferson.